My dear friends, in this video you will see phacoemulsification under topical anesthesia of a grade 4 nuclear sclerosis patient. After making both side port, inject the 0.6% tripen blue dye in the anterior chamber, and after 6 to 10 seconds wash it thoroughly, and then inject 2% HPMC like this, and then do the continuous curvilinear capsular axis of good size, about 5 to 6 millimeter size. While making the axis, I have to keep in our mind that the IUL margins should be covered with the axis margin, and in soft cataract you can make smaller axis, while in hard cataract we have to make a good sized axis or larger axis. Inject some HPMC and then make posterior limbal main port. See, it is a posterior limbal incision, and then do the hydro procedure, hydro dissection and hydro delineation. Tape the nucleus slightly, gently, and try to rotate it. After hydro procedure, inject some HPMC and then rotate the nucleus from right side port. Rotation of the nucleus indicate there is no corticocapsular additions. Now I am starting phacoemulsification. In this patient you will see a modified direct chop. First make the trench after emulsifying superficial cortex in US1 mode. After making trench, rotate the nucleus about 45 degree and embed the phaco tip in the nucleus and go to US2 mode. Hold the nucleus and then chop it like this. This nucleus is harder. Now rotate again and embed the phaco tip. Build up some vacuum, hold the nucleus and then chop it. Make multiple chops like this. After making multiple chops, lift any one nuclear piece and then emulsify it in US3 mode. Emulsify every quadrant 1x1 Always remember, use FECO energy at correct time. Second, use FECO energy only for the emulsification. Unnecessary wastage of energy in the AC is not a good practice. After emulsifying, every part of the nucleus remove the remaining cortex by using Cinco cannula or bimanual cannula. Now go to the US4 mode, that is epinucleus mode. Remove the epinucleus like this, and then after emulsification of the epinucleus, remove remaining part of the cortex with the help of Cinco cannula. Inject some HPMC and then remove the cortex. While removing the cortex with Cinco cannula, always keep in your mind that the aspiration port of the cannula should not face towards the posterior capsule. It should be always towards the capsular margin or anteriorly. If you will make such practice, then there will be least chances of the posterior capsular rupture while removing the cortex. See, this is a hydro polish. Again, see, this is hydro polish. Jet of the fluid is sufficient to remove the cortical fiber which are stuck to the lens capsule. Inject some HPMC and then implant the intraocular lens. This is hydrophobic aspheric intraocular lens. First, inject the lens leading haptics in the bag, and then with the help of lens dialer rotate the trailing haptics and make sure it is in the bag. After implanting the IUL, remove the entire HPMC from the anterior chamber and from the posterior surface of the lens. Don't leave any part of the HPMC inside the anterior chamber. Thus, after implanting the IUL, inject pilocarpine intracamerally and wash it. Then inject preservative free moxifloxacin and then hydrate the wound. After hydration of the wound, check the wound leakage, and thus case is concluded. Thank you very much.